Hello.
I read another one of my favorite books, and it's for Telling That Story, written by Jill Murphy.
Well done. Okay, so this one, we need lots of imagination. Okay?
Yes. So imagine. So this is an imagination book.
It is a book with imagination. Can I go to the moon? Asked Baby Bear. No, you cannot, said Mrs. Bear. It's bath time. Anyway, you'd have to find a rocket first. Baby Bear found a rocket in the cupboard under the stairs. Well, I think that's a sensible place to keep a rocket, don't you?
Yeah.
He found a space helmet on the draining board in the kitchen.
In the kitchen.
And a pair of space boots on the mat by the front door. Now, we have our own space helmet. Just for Crystal. I don't think it's going to stay on your head. Is it going to stay on your head? What about on Daddy's head? Will it stay on Daddy's head? Okay, Daddy will have to go into space.
Yeah, me too.
He packed his teddies and some food for the journey and then took off up the chimney. Wow.
Wow, this is exciting.
Whoosh.
Whoosh.
Out into the night.
That might be very fun.
I think it is fun. I can feel this falling. Just then, an owl flew past. That's a smart rocket, he said. Where are you off to? The moon, said Baby Bear. Would you like to come too? Yes, please, said the owl.
It's not
going to be your head. I don't think it is. Oh, no, it fell. An aeroplane roared out of the clouds. Baby Bear waved, and some of the passengers waved back. So, hello. Hello. What do you think some of the passengers thought?
Crazy.
Oh my, there's a bear in the sky.
Crazy bear.
Crazy bear in a box flying with an owl. On and on they flew, up and up, above the clouds, past millions of stars, till at last they landed on the moon.
So you can use your own imagination of where you're going to go up in the sky.
Sounds good. There's nobody here, said Baby Bear. There's no trees, said the owl. It's a bit boring, said Baby Bear. Shall we have a picnic? What a good idea, said the owl. Now, what would you have if you had a picnic on the moon?
I would have a pie and a cup of orange juice.
Oh, that sounds very nice. I think I would have a cup of tea and some lemon cake.
I'm out of my mind.
You're out of your mind, are you?
Yeah.
Not out of this world?
Out of my mind and the world.
Oh my gosh. Okay. We'd better go, said Baby Bear. My bath must be ready by now. And off they went, down and down. The owl got out and flew away. Goodbye, he said. It was nice to have met you.
That was very nice.
It started to rain, and the rain dripped through Baby Bear's helmet. Now, I don't think this is very waterproof, do you?
No.
So I think Bear might be getting a little bit wet.
Because it has holes.
It has holes in it, that's right. Home went Baby Bear, back down the chimney and onto the living room carpet with a
tumble.
And tumble, but what did you land with? A
chump.
A chump? He landed with a...
rump.
A rump? He landed with a... bump.
Bump.
With a bump. Mrs. Bear came into the room. Look at the state of you, she gasped, as she led him away to the bathroom. Why, it looks like you've been up the chimney. He has been up the chimney, hasn't he? As a matter of fact, said Baby Bear, I have been up the chimney. I found a rocket and went to visit the moon. Mrs. Bear laughed. You and your stories, she said. Whatever next? And then Baby Bear looks very smart and tired in his pajamas, all ready for bed. Say goodnight, Baby Bear.
Goodnight, Baby Bear.
We hope you enjoyed our story.
We hope it was fun.
And we'll see you again next time.
And I hope you use your imagination. See you again next time.
Bye.
Bye.